Hi guys, welcome to Code Artisan Lab. This is our second video of our Django patient record application. And in this video, we will install Django and create our application. So let's do this. So we will open the command line and I am in the folder Django apps. And we will open the command line. And before running the Django command, please ensure that you have installed Python. And if you have not installed Python, then you can install from python.org. So from this website, you can install Python. So I am running the Python latest version. So you can go to the downloads and here you can download the Python and install that. After the installing the setup, you can ensure with Python command, if you run this command, this will show the Python interpreter. So we will exit from this. And now we will install Django. So you can install Django with pip. So this pip command comes with Python. So you can run pip install Django. Okay. So this command will install Django in your system. Okay. So after running this command, after installing the Python and after installing the Django, we will create the project. So let's create the project. So we will run this command Django admin start project and our project name will be patient record. Okay. So after running this command will create the patient record application. So here you can see we have a patient record folder and in this we have another patient record folder. And in this, we have a setting for this project. Now, what we will do, we will create the application. So, currently we have created the project. So, project can contain the multiple application. So, you can say the application is like a module of the system, of the software. Like if we are creating the blog application, then comments is a module. User profile is another module and a post is another module. So these are module interact as an application and this is our main project. So our main project is patient record and now we will create the application. So we will go to the folder patient record and then we will create the application. So now we are in the folder so we can run the start app. Main. Okay, so I'm going to create the main application. The application name is main. So these are the important steps to remember whenever you create the Django application or Django project. So we have created the main application. Now what we need to do, the next step is we will open the setting file. We will open the setting project level setting file. So we will open this file. And after open this file, we will add the application. We will register the application to the project. Okay. Now what we will do, we will run this application. So py manage.py. So this is the command line. Command line tool. So now we are running py manage.py run server. Okay, so now it is saying that starting development server at this port. So we will go to the 127. So this port. So here we have successfully installed the Django. Now we will create the simple I'm going to create a simple admin site admin panel which comes with Django. Just we need to give some commands to create the admin panel. So let's create this admin panel quickly. So we will stop the server and what we will do, we will create the migration. So py manage.py migrate. So whenever you install Django, so Django So Django comes with default database, that is SQLite. So, and it is also comes with lots of tables. So we have created the tables, we have migrated the these tables. And now what we will do, because before creating the admin panel, we need to migrate the existing tables. So we have migrated that. Now we will run the command to create the admin panel. So py manage.py create super user. Okay, so this will ask for the name admin. I will empty the email address and the I will fill the password, and it is saying that password is too short, so I'll go to okay, no problem. And now, so super user created successfully. So now what we will do, we will run the server. So we have created the super user, we have created the admin user, so that we can easily log in the admin panel. So you can log in the admin panel with this URL admin, and now we have created the username and we have also created the password. So this is the admin panel that Django provides us. It has default model, groups and users. We will discuss about this in our upcoming videos. So we have you can see how easily we have installed the Django. We have created the admin panel. So this is powerful feature of Django. We can take lots of help from this admin panel, and we will create our project. So in this video, I just want to show you that how we can install Django and how we can create the admin panel with the help of commands. So in the next video, we will create our database schema for our application, because database schema is most important part. And we will create the database schema, then we will create the templates, and we will create the other logics. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video, and if you have any thoughts and any ideas or any improvement, then please add in the comment section, and please like this video, subscribe this channel, and share this video. Thank you so much.